bear listens to the wind. He's bored, bored, bored.
Barbara Bush in the children's hospital that bears her name, doing one of the things she loved most, reading to kids. Literacy, such an indelible part of her legacy. That was in 2014, her most recent visit, one of many through the nearly 20 years it's been in her name.
It's very hard for me to believe that you'd want to name the hospital after me. But if my name helps in any way for you to build an even better way for caring for children, then I am doubly honored.
That was the former First Lady in 1995, the year it was announced her name would be added to the pediatric inpatient facility. 3 years later, at the ribbon cutting, the woman who often avoided the spotlight explained how that came to be when philanthropist Elizabeth Noyce insisted it be so.
That she was going to donate $3 million only if I permitted them to use my name. How could I turn down an offer like that? It really was the nicest kind of blackmail.
As a mother herself who lost a young daughter to leukemia, she was always a champion of the kids' care.
Anyone with a sick child expects to get the kind of treatment that you have been giving and you will be giving our children.
And always willing to sit down with them and open a good book, like Mrs. Peachtree's Bicycle.
She teetered, and she tottered, and she wavered, and she swayed. Oh, fiddle faddle, she cried. And down she went.
Providing care in the way she could, lending her name, her time, and her compassion. Steve Botari, WMTW News 8.